have a fork on my wall. Okay, goodbye.
Welcome
to
MMS
News.
Now,
roll
the
intro.
Amazing things.
Good welcome, MMS, and good welcome to you, Layla.
Good welcome to you, too, Allison. And welcome to another great episode of MMS News Social Quarantine Distance Special Edition. So remember, we will still be focusing on character traits even though we are still 6 feet away from each other and not MMS.
And this one's character traits.
Fairness means to make judgments that are free from discrimination.
If you see someone being fair, either a student or a teacher on one of your online classes, go to the MMS News website.
And fill out the survey to see your name scroll across the screen.
Now we go to our exciting first story of the week. This is the Countering in the Amazing Spectacular MMS News Special Interview,
where our very own news reporters continue to get to know all of your favorite MMS personalities.
Hi, I'm Riley.
Hi, I'm Haley. Today in the MMS Spotlight, we have Dr. Comez. What is Winter Running Club and how can kids join?
Hi, everyone. Winter Running Club is an after-school activity that allows us to get together and be active and not do something school-based with some of your fellow classmates. We meet Tuesdays and Thursdays at 2:30. The easiest way to join is just to sign up for our Google Classroom. Coach Rossetti and myself have emailed out a couple of things, but you can just shoot me an email, acomas@d15.org, and say, I wanna join, and we'll get you in there. The nice thing about Running Club is it's for anyone of any abilities. If you've never ran a day in your life or you run marathons, we can make this club work for you. We spend a lot of time hanging out together in a Google Meet, warming up together, exercising together, laughing with each other. And then we put together a running workout that people can go ahead and give a try, or they can walk it, or they could skip it. But we would love to have you guys there joining us and having some fun after school and being active.
What work does someone have to do to earn a doctorate?
There's a lot of work goes into getting a doctorate. A lot of reading of textbooks, a lot of research, but the big thing that getting a doctorate entails is writing what's called a dissertation. So I had to do a research project using my middle school students, and I had to write all that research and scientific experimenting that I did into this nice 180-page book that I then had to get approved by professors. And I had to give a big presentation to a room full of people way smarter than me. And they had to determine whether or not my work was good enough to earn the degree.
What advice do you have for remote learning in COVID times?
My biggest advice is be proactive. You know, it's hard when you're kind of on your own and you're separated from your teachers and you're kind of by yourself. The more that you do to put yourself out there, sending people email, typing in chats, joining things like Running Club, the more you're going to feel connected to people and not so alone when you find something that's frustrating or hard. But remember that this is hard for everybody and teachers too, and we got your back. So if you're having a tough go of things, reach out to someone, a teacher, social worker, a friend. You'll see that you got a whole community of people there to support you surviving remote learning.
How many swords do you have in medieval weapons?
I have a lot. I haven't exactly counted them all, but I would have somewhere in the realm of probably 15 to 20 different swords, arrows, staves, that sort of thing. I keep one on my desk in front of me. So, yeah, they're kind of fun.
Thank you for letting us interview you, Dr. Comez. Bye, MMS. Have a great weekend.
The master of the calendar and the knower of all the holidays has your weekly calendar update.
Hello and welcome back, MMS, to this week's calendar update. Make sure to check your calendar for this upcoming National Day. Today, I'll be talking about National Pretend to be a Time Traveler Day on Tuesday, December the 8th. You can celebrate this day by dressing up like you're from another decade. You can dress from the past or future. You can even act like you're from another decade, too. For example, pretend to be confused by modern technology, or talk about pretend future invention. That's it for today. What decade will you dress up as? As always, remember, be safe, wear a mask, and social distance. But most importantly, happy National Time Traveler Day.
We go now to a great news story that will be our very special event story for this month,
where we send our very own reporters around the world to see how they celebrate this holiday season.
Hi, and welcome to a new story called Holidays Everywhere. And today we'll be learning about Germany and how they celebrate Christmas, because Christmas is right around the corner.
In Germany, Christmas is celebrated with Christmas trees in your home. Preferably real ones, because plastic ones are frowned upon. Another way they celebrate Christmas is by using advent calendars. They have wreath advent calendars like this one, and they have wooden ones.
Three fun facts about Germany is that Germany celebrates Christmas with two public holidays, the 25th and the 26th of December. The second fun fact is that the traditional Christmas meal is roast goose with potato dumplings and red cabbage. Our last fun fact is that their Christmas tree is usually put up on Christmas Eve after it is decorated.
Christmas celebrations start in Germany on the 24th of December, Christmas Eve, when the gifts are exchanged. On the 25th, Christmas Day, and the 26th, usually the family gets together to celebrate.
I hope you liked our new story, Holidays Everywhere, and tune in for next week when we take another trip to see what holidays look like everywhere else.
Bye, and have a great weekend, MMS.
The MMS DIYers have crafted another special project to help you pass the time this weekend.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another great episode of DIY.
This week, we'll be making alcohol marker paintings.
In order to make this, you will need a canvas, rubbing alcohol, about a half cup, but depending on the size of your canvas, you might need a little more or less, a garbage bag, some tape, and some Crayola washable markers.
The first thing you want to do is tape the garbage bag to your work surface because this craft can get a little messy.
Now for the next step, you want to color in your canvas using your markers in little sections like this. The next step, you might want to have an adult help you.
Next, you want to slowly pour the rubbing alcohol onto the canvas and start tilting the canvas to get the rubbing alcohol to spread across the canvas, blending the markers together.
Now you want to let your canvas dry, and you're done!
This is a fun and quick craft, and I think you'll have fun making it.
If you make this or have a suggestion for next week's craft, email me at aevager420@d15.org.
Or me at mcenter217@d15.org, and maybe your idea or picture will end up in MMS News.
Goodbye, MMS, and remember to stay crafty.
The screen is on, the popcorn is cooking, and the couch is warm, so settle in and learn the latest movie streaming this soon.
Hello, MMS, it's Mackenzie. Today I'm going to be talking about the movie Croods 2. You can watch the movie in select theaters, or you can rent it to watch it at home. Some people who are starring in the movie are Ryan Reynolds, Emma Stone, and Nicolas Cage. The movie is about the prehistoric Crood family discovers an idyllic paradise that meets all of its needs. Unfortunately, they must also learn how to live with better mans. If you are interested in Croods 2, make sure to watch it in your free time. Goodbye, MMS. Have a great day.
The Top 10 is back again with another list of the best jams to blow up your headphones, so plug in and pay attention. Welcome back, MMS. Here's your favorite part of the MMS News, the Top 10. So let's see where your favorite songs rank this week. First on our list at number 10 is Kings and Queens by Ava Max. And our number 9 is It's Okay Not to Be Okay by Demi Lovato and Marshmello. Say, it's okay not to be okay. It's okay not to be okay. And our number 8 is a requested song, Breathe Deeper by Tama Tamali. And number 7 is Happy by Dixie D'Amelio. Just don't want to explain it, but sometimes I don't want to be happy. Don't hold it against me. If I'm down, just leave me there. Let me be. At our number 6 is Be Kind by Hazley and Marshmello. You can cry to the one, always confide in the one. You can be kind to the one that you love. Halfway down our list, at our number 5 is Run by Laura Marano. Number 4 is Fade by Driver Era. It's all just gonna fade off away. At our number three is Falling by Harry Styles. At our number two is Daisies by Katy Perry. Last time on the list, at number one is Long Live by Florida Georgia Line. Long live nights like these. Long live, long live, long live, long live nights like these. Goodbye, MMS. Have an amazing weekend and keep jamming out from 6 feet apart.
Want to know your favorite celebs' junk food or what they like to buy from Target? Then pay attention to this week's Celeb Fact Report.
Hello, MMS. It's your girl, Savannah, coming back with interesting facts about the celeb Don Cheadle, suggested by Mr. Reading. So, let's get into it. Don Cheadle has two children named Anami and Anaya. Don is an American actor, author, director, producer, and writer. He is 56 years old. He is born in Kansas City, Missouri, United States, on November 29th, 1964. His full name is Donald Frank Cheadle. Don has been in at least 49 movies. He is mostly popular in the Avenger movies. If you have celebrity suggestions, email me at sjoes433@d15.org. Bye, MMS. Have a great day.
The players are stretched and ready to throw it to this week's Sports Center for all the latest who is playing.
Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of Sports Talk. In NCAA football, we have Illinois not playing because of COVID-19. Illinois will play Iowa tomorrow. Number 8 Northwestern lost this week 29-20 to Michigan State and going down to 5-1 this season, and now the number 16 in the country. The now number 16 Northwestern was canceled because of COVID-19. The number 12 Indiana is now the number 10 and 5-1 on the season by beating Maryland 27-11. The number 10 Indiana will play Wisconsin tomorrow. The number 2 Notre Dame beat North Carolina 31-17. The number 2 Notre Dame will play Syracuse tomorrow. Now let's hand it over to Justin with the NFL.
Hi, I'm Mess, and the NFL games this week are the Saints vs. the Falcons, Browns vs. the Texans, Lions vs. the Bears, Bengals vs. the Dolphins, Jaguars vs. the Vikings, Colts vs. the Texans, Raiders vs. the Jets, Giants vs. the Seahawks, Rams vs. the Cardinals, Patriots vs. the Chargers, Eagles vs. the Packers, Broncos vs. the Chiefs, Washington vs. the Steelers, Bills vs. the 49ers, and on Tuesday night, we have the Cowboys vs. the Ravens. Have a good week, MMS. Stay safe. Wear a mask and stay 6 feet apart.
Now we go to a brand new story, straight up from the Sports Center. Nate is here with some facts about your favorite sports logos.
Hi, and welcome to Logo of the Week. This week's logo is the current Houston Texans logo. That logo has been there since 2002. The logo represents the Texas flag, and the 5 points of the star on the logo represent pride, courage, strength, tradition, and independence. The logo is a Spanish fighting bull, which was chosen to represent the spirit of Texas. In 1997, the local NFL team, the Houston Oilers, moved to later become the Tennessee Titans. So a local businessman named Bob McNair tried to create a National Hockey League team, but failed, so he focused on football and created the Houston Texans. If you have an idea for next week's logo, email me at nmiller743@d15.org. Bye, MMS.
The food critics reviewed all the menus, called DoorDash, and are waiting to give you this latest food report.
Hello, MMS. It's Marissa.
And Addie.
Today's restaurant was requested by Allison Akey.
She requested Safe House, which is located in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
A few items they have on their brunch menu is the B1 Bomber,
the Safe House Skillet. On their lunch menu, they serve Spy Sliders,
Bird Watchers,
and Green Bean Missiles, and much, much more.
We are going to skip dinner because there's too much on that list.
It's sort of like an escape room because you need a secret password to enter.
Their website is safehouse.com.
is a great place to host a birthday party for young children to middle-aged adults.
St. Bob's has a 4.3 star review out of 5 stars.
Right now, it is temporarily closed, but I'm sure once COVID's over, you can make a sneak attack up to Milwaukee and dine there.
To be exact, it is located at 779 N French Street, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
That's all for today, MMS.
Make sure to investigate Steakhouse.
But you might want to keep a lookout while doing so.
Anyways,
remember to wear your mask while you're eating.
We go now to the latest list from the top three that is sure to keep you talking and debated all the weekend long.
Hello, MMS. Welcome back to Top 3. Today, I'm going to talk about breakfast. You know, the most important meal of the day. Number 3, we have oatmeal. Oatmeal is very filling and healthy. It also tastes great when you wake up, is what my sister said. And number 2, we have fresh fruit. Fresh fruit is also very filling, and it tastes great with yogurt. Not only is it very filling, but it can also look pretty on special occasions. Finally, and number 1, we have eggs. There are so many ways you can eat eggs. For example, scrambled, runny, hard-boiled, etc. You can also add some spices like garlic, Cajun, and salt and pepper. Also, eggs are very easy to cook and can take like 5 minutes. Well, that is it for top 3, and if you have any suggestions, please email me at esmith462@d15.org. Goodbye, MMS, and have a fantastic weekend.
The cutest with the most likely to bite your face off are here, so take it away, Animal Jam.
Hey, MMS! It's your girls, Rebecca.
Abby.
Bria. I am from the Halloween Animals.
Today we're going to be doing top 3 holiday animals.
Number 3 is the reindeer. The reindeer is also known as the caribou in North America.
Number 2 is the turkey. The turkey is oftenly found as a large bird and is known in the USA.
Number 1 is the black cat associated with Halloween. They're commonly found with witches and mostly associated with witches because they're said to bring bad luck.
That's it. Thanks for watching. And if you have any suggestions, make sure you email us at aptera651@d15.org.
rhauk621@d15.org.
And if you want to email me at blaric706@d15.org.
That's it.
Bye, MMS. And remember,
when in doubt, meow it out.
Our very own special blend of That Can't Be Right and Please Tell Me You Didn't Waste Money on That is back again with this week's rip-off review.
Welcome, MMS, to the most ripped-off segment of the year, the segment where we will all get brain damage. So, for this week, you will need a nice glass of milk to make these rip-offs go down smoother. First on the list of ripped-off Oreos are Cream Betweens. Tastes like a rip-off. Second, we have Mario's Best. And the name is totally original. Third is chocolate and vanilla, cream, choco, vanilla, any kid's dream treat. Last on our list isn't actually off-brand, but it's just straight confusing. Cookies and cream Oreos. Well, that fills our bellies with the rip-offs. That's all we need. So, goodbye, MMS, and have a great weekend.
Now we go to the latest thing blowing up the screen with this week's Science Minute.
Hi, MMS, and welcome to this week's Scientific Minute. Sadly, I cannot do the Science Minute with Turnip Top Timmy, Grace, and Lil Bonnie Bonkers, Megan. But instead, I have a super fun experiment for this week. Fruit volcanoes. You will need an orange or a lemon of your you can choose. I chose an orange. Vinegar and baking soda. First, you're going to want to cut the top off of your orange or lemon and gut out the insides. Then you're going to add 3 or 4 tablespoons of baking soda. I added 3, but if you have a bigger orange, you're going to add 4. Next, either add 1/4 of a cup of vinegar or 1/2 a cup of vinegar. Add it to your orange. And there you go. What happens here is very similar to what happened to the exploding lunch bag I did a few weeks ago. When the acidic vinegar meets the base baking soda, it causes carbon dioxide to form. It makes the orange look like it's exploding. Thank you. Thanks for watching, and always believe in science. It fixes everything.
MMS News proudly presents the vacancy for all of the things that make you sick with this week's medically approved JFL.
Hello, MMS. Welcome back to another great week of MMS News. Our names are Peyton
and Steve, and welcome to JFL.
And since we are getting ready for December and waiting for the snow to fall and to drink a bunch of hot cocoa, we decided to show you some fails that show that December isn't always the best. Now, let's get in.
At number one, we have the unlucky dog.
Is this cool or what?
That dog must be confused and think he has superpowers.
Next up at number two, we have the lesson that everyone should have already learned. Ooh, should have brought ice skates.
At number three, we have the slapping penguin.
Like a kudgy.
That penguin must have owed him something.
And lastly, at number four, we have the downhill fall.
Anyways, that's all for today, MMS, and if you have any funny videos, be sure to email me at sherrera606@d15.org.
Or me at pevanna107@d15.org.
Bye, MMS, and keep on laughing.
Have a great day, MMS, and remember to stay classy from like 6 feet away and wash your hands, please.